friends, how are you? So, just want to say again, thanks to my brother for getting me a new camera. It is a better quality. I just have to be careful when I move. It's more light sensitive, and because it is, it can very easily go out of focus and very hard time getting back into focus, which is irritating. But that being said, welcome to Anime Thursday, where as of right now, this segment is pretty much geared towards really laid back, really fun, fluffy slice of life anime. With My Hero Academia coming out on Mondays, with My Hero Mondays, I thought, well, you know what? I really want to do something for anime. I thought it'd be really, really fun. Wouldn't it be great to do something more slice of life, a lot like Dumbbell Down Kilimanjaro, but also have a little bit of like information for you. And that's what this, definitely this series is geared towards along a lot of ways. With Dumbbell Down Kilimanjaro, again, go check out those reactions. A lot of it was fitness and working out, and I work out and I do fitness stuff, so some of it I was able to comment on. I've never been camping, so everything that I'm learning in this episode is pretty new for me, so I don't really have anything to comment against, but really just enjoying it. Last few episodes have been so much fun, less about information, though we have gotten a little bit here and there, more about the development of relationships, specifically between Rin and Nadeshiko. Their dynamic and their relationship is very cute, very sweet, and the growth of it has been adorable, especially also the growth between Nadeshiko, Aki, and Ao. Ao, the three members of the Outdoor Activities Club. And then we've gotten some guest appearances from the best friend of Rin as well. I am sick right now. Odds are when this video comes out, I'll be a bit much better or dead, which means this video won't come out, but whatever. Anyway, I'll be much better, but right now I'm sick. Very congested, very stuffed up, have a bit of a headache now. But I was hoping to kind of get ahead a little bit in terms of recording some anime, so that's what I'm doing right now. Something kind of fun and light and fluffy, nothing too deep to think about. Didn't pause as much the last episode because I was kind of out of it, but maybe I'll do a bit more pause in this episode if need be. And yeah, that's kind of it. Should be a lot of fun. Let's just dive right in. So she likes space. So last episode, she shared a book on UFOs, and now she's reading a book on the cosmos. Which means the year's only gonna get colder. Ooh, that's hot. She's done a lot of sightseeing. Oh, she got Nadeshiko a gift. She is not a morning person. She is so not awake. Oh, so it is her mother. Okay. What is it? Oh, wow, that's look really cool. She's so proud. I really, really love this intro. It's so cute. It's such a fun intro.
I guess not.
I guess not. Maddie! Maddie!
Very cute.
Nice. Ooh, very cool. Ooh. That's just as amazing. Her friend dies. A metal offertory box. Yeah, solo. Ugh. Worked out, wow. Oh, ribeye, that'd be nice. A lot of. Can you have to pack that all that with you, you goofball? Well, might be a little melted by then. Saito. She would. Kind of as a girl. Her best friend's so funny. You should give her a gift soon. Should though. Oh, look at her little red nose with how cold it was. Probably. There's a Deshiko. Asleep in the library. Ah! Oh! Kicked your gun. Okay. They weren't talking for that long. She must have fallen asleep like that. She'll probably even like 5 minutes. Oh, eat it. So I love the little moments where we get to see kind of just Rin react to Nadeshiko, because it's just how, I mean, Nadeshiko is such a puppy, and I think it really amuses everybody around her. They kind of she kind of endears themselves to her, but we do kind of see early on that Nadeshiko really has worked her way into Rin's heart and just endeared herself to her so fast that this little, quiet, sort of closed off individual who really has only one best friend, Saito, who probably, was probably one of those kids that were like, we're gonna be friends, and that was it. So, it is very cute to see how quickly and how, just the affection that, Rin has for Nadeshiko. It's very, very cute. Look very delicious. Wow, between the two of them, they ate almost all of them but one. Majority probably were eaten by Nadeshiko. Oh well, that's what I was thinking. Oh well. Oh yeah, so Red's just eaten one. Oh nice! Rin's mom meeting Nadeshiko's sister. Borrowed your daughter. Very cute. That is. Very cute. Very nice. Also, Nadeshiko's sister is so nice taking her places and staying with her places. She's so wonderful. They said this last time, the little details of like of her like using her brakes one time on her bike, the way she kind of maneuvered on a rock, just her like the Nadeshiko's sister partially being in the mirror, and then Rin kind of sliding into the mirror. It's little details like that that really add kind of a realism and a fun. It just really makes like the directing of this anime is really, really good. I don't know if some of the scenes we see are also in the manga, but the director of animation for this anime has done a really phenomenal job with the backgrounds being so beautifully, like the landscapes being so beautifully hand painted, and just little details in the animation. It's just really, really impressive. They can be, yeah. Sometimes I can just take a nap in my car. Yeah, I guess she is. Still waiting. This one here is kind of blah. That's so mean. Oh, Chan. Oh, cool. Now we're getting the different kinds of campgrounds. Probably too cold for the winter. Grasslands would be nice, but there's a lot of wind. Vista would be beautiful. We've seen Lakeside.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. She just takes every little detail and just goes psh with it, doesn't she? She's so dramatic in a very freaky way. That's with the skin. Nice. Wow, she's buying a little bit of everything. What's with her eyes? Oh, she may not eat as much as Nadeshiko, but she definitely loves food a lot. So they have only a few varieties. Oh my gosh. Even Rin can be dramatic in her own little way. Oh my gosh. It's funny to see that even Rin, when we start peeling back her layers, is goofy and dramatic and just kind of silly. It just takes somebody like maybe her best friend Saito, or even Nadeshiko kind of just being around her more and seeing her like. So it takes her a while, her more in her personality to come out. It's very cute. That's a lot of me, though. It's a lot of money. Don't forget the canned coffee for your sister. Oh. Do we remember the canned coffee? So Shimmerin's her full name. Doesn't smell very good, does it? Their sibling dynamic is very on par. Oh, so then they decided to go camping too. Or at least she did. Oh, so Aki's going camping by herself to scope out a campground. It's beautiful. I'm gonna pause real quick. I just wanna pause a little bit more often throughout this episode. I do love the fact that the outdoor club isn't like they just call themselves the outdoor club, but they really aren't. Like, they really wanna be adventurous and they are trying, but it just took like that third party excited person to really to get them moving. And I do love the fact that they're not just like pretending to be an outdoor activities club, but they're really trying to be. And they actually really enjoy being outdoors. It's really nice. Oh, so he might be, I suppose we, yeah, it kind of does. So he must be a really well-seasoned camper. I'm here. About medium rare. Comes across as dramatic, but he's just a nice guy out there. Classy old grandpa. That's so funny. That was kind of funny and dramatic. All of our dramatics with people, all of our interactions with people are so dramatic. Okay, so it is right, yeah. Doggy Dash. Like everybody views her as a puppy. Wow, it's gorgeous. Kagabiara. Okay. Oh, that's nice. She's so nice. Yeah, she is nice. I know chai means just tea in general. And then in the States, when you get chai tea, which I know is a little bit, what's the word? Pedantic? It's like Panera bread, like the restaurant, like Panera's bread in a different language. So you're saying bread. I know that, again, the point is that when you're in the States specifically and you're ordering chai tea, you're ordering a specific kind of tea. aspect of kind of black tea anyway. That's why people say chai tea in the States versus just saying chai. Or you could just say chai instead, and that works out well too. Looks like even drawing the Deshiko around, she gets a chance to kind of explore a little bit of the area too. But a cow ghost too, cow ghost. Is that the end of the episode? It looks like the episodes are kind of done in two-parters in a way, which is funny. And now we're getting the normal outro. Shagbird? Huh. Oh! Soba udon. Soba udon. Nah. So that episode was really, really cute. Again, not too much in terms of information. We learned a little bit about that grill, which is really cool. And we got to see Aki doing some really fun, I guess recon is the word. Kind of checking out some other campsites for them to do, which is really awesome. I love getting to see them actually enjoy camping and look into doing camping all year round, especially when, you know, when it's cold, you probably wouldn't want to, but it is really cool to see that they really are enthusiastic about camping. They just really haven't had too many people to go camping with, and the Deshiko's presence really has kind of affected a lot of people. Well, a lot of people, really the ones we see are specifically Aki and Al. And Rin, of course. Rin, I think, being greatly affected by Nadeshiko more than anything. And it is interesting to see, now that we've established that the blue-haired, short-haired woman is Rin's mom, why... And I hope we get to see get more background, and maybe this will get it in the following couple episodes. But it'd be interesting to see why Nadeshiko lives with her sister and not her parents, what the story is behind that. A lot of, I do love a lot of these laid-back, live, fluffy kind of slice life episodes. A TV show, seasons usually, where is it, she? Again, there's not too much angst or action, but sometimes there is a little bit of a sadness to some of the episodes, to some of the characters. Characters losing family or whatever. Again, my favorite being Sakura Quest, which is really cute. Anyway... not much else to say. Really fun episode, really solid. The directing was really cute. I love these little moments they have. So much of this episode, I think you get more out of what's not being said than being said. Usually a lot of these episodes are filled with a lot of dialogue, but this particular anime is very much a lot of it is visual. And not as much on the dialogue. The dialogue's pretty sparse, or at least 50-50, which is what I'm not really used to. Even most fluffy slice-of-life animes, there's a lot more dialogue I'm used to experiencing. So it's kind of interesting that these episodes are very laid-back and very quiet compared to what I'm used to. But anyway, really fun, very cute, really loved it. Again, I love the development of Nadeshiko and Rin's relationship. It's very cute, very sweet. I really do enjoy it. And I do love how sweet her Nadeshiko's sister is, how she is willing to drive so far, and kind of uses these moments of taking her sister places to actually enjoy time as well, enjoy these new locations that she probably would never have gotten to if it wasn't for her sister dragging her about. That being said, again, a fun anime, really solid. I can't wait to see what this next episode brings. Looks like it might bring some hilarity, especially with Nadeshiko being frightened of ghosts. Anyway, thank you so much for being for watching this video. Right now, I'm dealing with some of that sinus issues, so a little bit of nasally. But again, thank you so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, share with your friends, share with your enemies. Go check out my My Hero Academia reactions right now. I'm doing something new where you when you click on the video that's published publicly, that's just a review, and then you can click on a unlisted video that has my actual reaction. I know it's a little two-stepper, but it's the only way to keep my videos from being blocked by Toho. And hopefully it'll actually work, and they won't be jerks about it. But it seems to be working so far, but I don't want to speak too soon. Anyway, like, comment, subscribe, share with your friends, share with your enemies, and I'll see you next time.